Let's work through a cross-product application example. So this example will be about magnetic force on a moving charge. So here's what it says. An electron which has a charge of negative 1.6 times 10 to the negative 19 coulombs moves along the x-axis in the positive direction with speed of 8 times 10 to the fifth meters per second. When it reaches the origin, a uniform magnetic field of strength 0.5 tesla is applied in the direction of the z-axis. Find the magnitude and direction of the force on the electron at the moment it enters the magnetic field. Okay, so what we have here is we have a particle with a charge, our electron in this case, and it has a certain charge that we know, and it's moving with a certain velocity, and it counters a magnetic field, which is given by a vector. And what we want to do is we want to find the force vector on the electron when it enters this magnetic field. Okay, so what we need to know to do this is basically the magnetic force on a moving charge. So that's given by the following. The force equals the charge Q, which is the scalar quantity, times vector V cross vector B. Now here vector V represents the velocity of the charge, and then vector B represents the magnetic field. Okay, so let's go ahead and try to apply the information we know to this formula. So we know Q, that's the charge of the electron, and that's negative 1.6 times 10 to the negative 19 coulombs. Okay, so that's a scalar quantity that's going to be out front. And then we're going to be taking the cross product of two vectors. So let's see if we can write down those vectors. Well, the first is vector V, which is the velocity of the charge. Now, we're told its speed, and that represents the magnitude of the velocity. And we're also told that it's moving along the x-axis in the positive direction. So if we wanted to use unit vectors, that'd be in the I direction, the positive I direction. So this is pretty nice. It's just in the x direction. So I can write my vector then as 8 times 10 to the fifth meters per second I hat. Cross. And now I need to write down my vector V. So the magnitude of vector V is this positive 0.5 teslas. And it's in the z-axis direction. Okay, so once again, that's a pretty nice vector to write. I'm just going to write 0.5 teslas in the k-hat direction. Okay, and now I'm just going to need to take this cross product. So let's leave the negative 1.6 times 10 to the negative 19 out here for a second. Now, as far as my number, I've got 8 times 10 to the 5th times 1 half. So that's 4 times 10 to the 5th. And this is, if I want to keep track of my units, Tesla meters per second. But what about the direction? So this is going to be I hat cross K hat. Okay. So we need to remember what I hat cross K hat is. So hopefully you recall that that's the negative j hat direction. So 4 times 10 to the 5th teslas meters per second, and this is in the negative j hat direction. Okay, so now I've got some constants to work out here. So let me calculate negative 1.6 times 10 to the negative 19th times 4 times 10 to the 5th. So that should give us 6.4 times 10 to the negative 14th. And now my units, I have Tesla, Coulomb, meters per second. And we'll work on those in a second. And then I have J hat. So how did this J hat become positive? Well, I have a negative out here from the negative charge, and then a negative J hat. So negative times a negative is positive, so that's how I end up with this positive J hat. And then 6.4 times 10 to the negative 14th is the magnitude. Okay, so what about those units? That's kind of funky. So let's see if we can get those units to work out to a unit of force. So 1 Tesla is a 1 kilogram over coulombs per second. So we have units of Teslas times coulombs times meters over second. So we substitute in this definition of the Tesla. That's going to give us kilograms times coulombs times meters over coulombs times second. So looks like we've got kilogram meters per second squared, 2 seconds down here. And this is actually the unit, or the units that make up a newton. And that makes sense because newton is a measure of force, a unit of force. So 6.4 times 10 to the negative 14 newtons, that's my magnitude. And the force is in the j-hat direction. So this is the magnitude and direction of the force on the electron at the moment it enters the magnetic field.